Hi, my name is Andy Kong. I'm a program manager on the Visual Studio team. I'm going to show you how to build a modern business application that extends the Office 365 experience with a new cloud business app project template in Visual Studio 2013. In our scenario, Contoso HR department has been using Office 365 to manage active job postings across the organization. We want to create a new application that allows individuals in the company to submit potential candidates for open positions from their Office 365 site using whatever devices they have available at the time. We will create this app with the new Cloud Business App project template. Let's create a new project in Visual Studio. We are creating an app for Office 365, so you can find the Cloud Business App project template under the Office and SharePoint for both VB and C#. This categorization is based on the language used in the middle tier. The client is HTML and JavaScript. You first need an Office 365 developer site to start building apps for Office and SharePoint. If you don't have an account for development, you can sign up for a free 30-day trial at dev.office.com. If you are a MSDN Premium subscriber, you will receive a one-year subscription as a benefit. Enter your SharePoint development site here. Cloud Business App is creating four projects for you in the solution. There is a server project, which is a basic ASP.NET project used to add tables and connect to data sources. There's a standard SharePoint project, which provides a connection to Office 365. There's a HTML client project, which is a JavaScript project that you define the UI for your app. Finally, there's a Cloud Business App project, which ties all the other projects together. Let's start by defining a new data model for candidates using the table designer. Click New Table. We will name this table Candidate. Let's add some field. We have a name and phone number. The tool provides a set of business types, such as phone number, email, and person. They come with specific validation logic and visualizations, both in the tooling and runtime. In this case, I will select phone number. Let's also add an email using email address and a refer by using the person type. And finally, we'll add an interview date of type date, and we'll mark that as optional. There's a growing trend in integrating social features in modern business applications. Cloud Business App make it easy by integrating with SharePoint's newsfeed feature. In the Properties window, you can enable Social under the Social category. Let's check Post when created, so when a new candidate is created, the app will post the activity to newsfeed. We'll also check Post when updated and specify which field will trigger the post. Let's select Interview Day. So the app will post a activity when the interview date is updated. Again, in our scenario, we assume that SharePoint list is currently being used to track open positions by the HR department. Here, we want to attach to this SharePoint list. I will click on Attach to External Data Sources. In Cloud Business Apps, you can attach to SQL, SharePoint, OData feed, or your own custom data sources. In this case, I'm connecting to a SharePoint site. I will enter the URL for my SharePoint list. It is now getting a list of contents from the SharePoint site. We will select job postings and click Finish. I now have a data model for job postings in my project. Relating data from different data sources in our case, SharePoint and SQL, and write business logic that works over both is one of the most powerful features in cloud business apps. Let's add a relationship between candidates and job postings. I'll click the relationship button. This dialog helps me define the relationship. In our case, we have a zero or one to many relationship between job postings and candidates. The dialog even spells out that relationship for you. So a job posting can have many candidate instances. A candidate can have one job posting. That sounds right. I'll click OK. And the tooling shows that relationship. Now we have defined the data model. Let's change our focus to designing the UI for this app. We will create a set of three screens and define the navigation flow between them. The first screen will show a list for browsing all the candidates already entered in the database. From there, the user can navigate to the second screen to add new candidate. Or the user can tap on a candidate to drill into the details with the third screen. Let's create the first screen via the context menu on the screens node. I will select Add Screen. Cloud Business App provides three screen templates that represent common UI patterns for browsing, viewing, adding, and editing data. In this case, we want a browse screen on the candidates. I will select candidates and click OK. A screen is created for you. In the screen designer, you see a screen content tree in the middle that represents the visual elements in the UI. Visual elements are bound to a data member on the left side of the designer. For example, in this screen, we have a list visual showing values from the candidate's dataset. We can also choose to render the dataset as a table or tile list. Let's choose tile list. We can also customize what will appear in the tile. So let's delete some fields. We can also make the name larger by changing the font. Next, I want to put an Add button on the screen that shows some UI for me to add candidate to the list. I will add an Add button in the command bar. You can write your own method for this button using JavaScript code, or in our case, we can choose from a set of commonly used functionalities. In this case, I want to add to the candidate's dataset. I will select that and click OK. The tool will guide us to create a new screen for adding a candidate. Let's name it Candidate Info. We can also do some customization. For example, we don't need job posting ID here. Let's delete that. Refer by is currently rendered as a person picker. We can also change the property so that it not only shows the name, it also shows the picture and title. Going back to the browse screen, we want to allow user to tap on the candidate to drill into more information. I can wire up the tap action for the list. In properties, there's a tap item property I can customize. You will bring up a similar dialog we saw earlier, except in this case, we will select View Selected. Again, it will guide us to create a new screen. When you F5 your app from Visual Studio, the app package is installed on SharePoint dev site and pointing to your application on localhost. The first time the app is deployed to your SharePoint developer site, a dialog asks you to approve a set of permissions. Finally, the app is loaded using single-page application architecture with a UI completely rendered by client-side code. Communication with the server is performed using async calls, resulting in a fast and fluid experience. This is the industry trend, and Cloud Business App handles all that for you. You can see we have a candidate list and an Add button to add a candidate. The list is currently empty, so let's add a new candidate. One thing to know is that all the layout adapts well to different form factors. Resizing the browser window will give you an idea of how the app might look on different devices. Everything is optimized for touch, but works equally well on desktop browser using keyboard and mouse. Let's enter some value. Since we specify phone and emails as business types during in the entity designer, we'll get some built-in validation logic. If I enter something that's not a phone number, I will get some error. Refer by value can be selected using an autocomplete box based on the active directory. I will pick myself. And job position can be selected from your attached SharePoint list via a picker. Let's save it. Now we can tap on the newly created candidate and view more details. Here you can see additional Office 365 integration on the details screen. This shows presence information for each person. You can send an IM, email, or schedule a meeting right here. Also, in business apps, it is common to have fields that track when and by whom an entity was created and last modified for auditing reasons. Cloud Business App does all that automatically for you. Let's say now we want to add an edit button on this screen, so we can also edit this candidate. For these types of UI tweaks on the screen, I can quickly make these changes without closing the browser and hit F5 again. I just need to go back to the designer, add a button to the command bar, I'll select edit, save all, and refresh the browser. Now I have an edit button on the screen. Let's update the interview data of this candidate. Remember when we created the candidate table, we enabled the social functionality. Now, if we open the newsfeed page, we will see some posts by the app. This is app's internal social feed. The newsfeed page has an entry for each newly created candidate and for each candidate that had the interview date changed. Clicking on a post will take you directly to the candidate details screen. User of the app can start a new conversation or like or reply to any posts. If you follow the app, the same social post and conversation will be posted to your personal feed. So far, we have a completely functional app now without writing a single line of code. Cloud Business App lets you focus your energy on the unique value of the app, the business logic. Let's say only the employees from the HR department should be allowed to schedule interviews for candidates. And we want to write some validation logic for that. Let's go to the candidates table. Business logic is written on the middle tier, which is represented by the server project in your solution. The table designer provides you with entry points into the data pipeline of your app. On the right code button, open the drop-down. Here, I see a list of code entry points for my business logic. I will choose candidates validate in this case. And let's write some code. If the interview date is already set, and application's current user, the department is not equal to HR, we will want some errors, and there's APIs for me to do that. Entering error message, only HR can schedule interviews. And I want the error to show up on the interview date field. Let's run the app again. We will update the interview day of this candidate. Since we wrote some validation logic on the middle tier, this will result in an error because you are not a member of the HR department. Finally, when I'm ready to publish this app to my organization, I can right-click on the Cloud Business App project and select Publish. Then I can follow the Publish wizard to step through different deployment options. To summarize, I've shown you a highly productive experience for defining data and screens that enable you to quickly get an app up and running. The app has a professional-looking UI that blends with SharePoint and is integrated with a set of Office 365 services. This allows you to focus on your business logic and get more done. Start building cloud business app today. There's a lot more in Visual Studio 2013. Please check out our blogs and forums to get more information. Thanks.